नमस्कार, सलाम। न्यूज़क्लिक के डेली राउंडअप में आपका स्वागत है। मैं हूं मुकुल सरल।
और मैं हूं सुमेधा।
सबसे पहले खास खबरें। शुरू करते हैं पहली खबर से। उत्तर प्रदेश के बिजनौर जिले में बहुजन समाज पार्टी के नेता हाजी एहसान और उनके भतीजे की गोली मारकर हत्या कर दी गई। लोकसभा चुनाव के 23 मई को परिणाम आने के बाद किसी राजनीतिक दल के कार्यकर्ताओं पर यह तीसरा बड़ा हमला है। यहां हत्यारे मिठाई के डिब्बे में पिस्तौल रखकर लाए थे और गोली मारकर फरार हो गए। आपको बता दें कि बिजनौर लोकसभा सीट बीएसपी के ही खाते में गई है। यहां से बीएसपी यानी गठबंधन प्रत्याशी मलूक नागर ने बीजेपी के पूर्व सांसद राजा भारतेंद्र सिंह को मात दी है। बिजनौर जिले के नजीबाबाद के रहने वाले हाजी एहसान बीएसपी के तो नेता थे ही, उनका प्रॉपर्टी का भी बड़ा कारोबार था। उनका इलाके में बड़ा नाम था, हालांकि उनके ऊपर भी कई मामलों में आरोप थे। आप याद रखें कि इससे पहले अमेठी में पूर्व ग्राम प्रधान और भाजपा नेता स्मृति ईरानी के करीबी सहयोगी की रविवार को गोली मारकर हत्या कर दी गई थी। गाजीपुर में सपा नेता और जिला पंचायत सदस्य विजय यादव की हत्या कर दी गई थी। इसके अलावा सोमवार को एक अन्य सपा नेता और पूर्व सांसद कमलेश वाल्मीकि को बुलंदशहर जिले में उनके आवास पर संदिग्ध परिस्थितियों में मृत पाया गया।
For our second story of the day, we are taking you to Mumbai in Maharashtra, where tribals from the RA Milk Colony have been constantly protesting over a significant amount of time. There were protests that were conducted even yesterday against relocation and the provision of basic facilities such as electricity and water. Today, we spoke to the tribal residents of the region and they mentioned to us as to how they've been living there for decades. But in order to favor the corporate interests, the tribals do not even get basic facilities such as electricity and water. And they have to struggle for the smallest of the things. There is a very clear strategy that the BJP government in the state of Maharashtra has been deploying to sort of relocate the tribals in order to give the important tribal land to the corporates as well. When we talk about the RA colony, there are 27 hamlets in the colony and they have been constantly protesting against the kind of corporate interest that is developing in the region and the allocation of multiple projects such as the Mumbai car shed project as well as the metro project which is taking place in the region, and a clearance has been given by the Maharashtra government for all these projects. And if the projects were to start taking place in the region, it is a possibility that about 2,000 families who live in RA colony can actually be displaced and they would have to shift to smaller two-story buildings where they're not used to living there in the first place at all, because these are tribal populations who are used to living in open spaces with cattle, with farm produce, and are now fearing that their land and their homes are being taken away from them. And there is a significant movement that has been building on the ground for a very long time now. And in April as well, there were protests in the colony and a legal battle is also being fought in the Supreme Court. Now, moving on to our third story as well, we're focusing on the rights of the workers. NREGA workers who've been employed in various states are at risk. They have been functioning under very dangerous working conditions. A recent example from Telangana shows that about 20 workers were trapped in a road accident which led to the death of one woman. These were predominantly women workers who were working on the field while they met with this accident, and many of them are critically injured as well and are battling for their lives in the hospital. And other two instances as well, two elderly men who were in their 50s and 60s, primarily from the marginalized communities of one being Dalit and the other man being a Muslim man, were also affected on the field. field of their work, where they experienced sunstrokes and they finally collapsed. One of them is critically ill right now and is constantly is battling for his life in the hospital as this is being recorded. And there are going to be more updates on this story. But what is important, and it's being pointed out by activists on the ground, is the situation of the workers again and again. Previously, last month in April, 10 women workers had also died in the state of Telangana, and many on the ground are stating that the situation of the workers are completely unsafe, where they're not even provided basic facilities such as water or shed over their heads, and they're working in the heat of about 45 degrees in the fields for farmers, and they're not even being given a cloth to cover their heads or being given water to take care of themselves while they are on this job. So it raises very important critical questions about the kind of social security that the state provides to its workers and the life and the value of the work that laborers do in India.
अब बात डॉक्टर पायल मामले की। मुंबई के डॉक्टर पायल तड़वी मामले में आरोपी तीनों डॉक्टर को गिरफ्तार कर लिया गया है। इन तीनों पर डॉक्टर पायल को जातिगत आधार पर प्रताड़ित करने का आरोप है, जिसकी वजह से मजबूर होकर उन्होंने आत्महत्या कर ली। इसे लेकर देश भर में आंदोलन भी हो रहे हैं। पुलिस के एक अधिकारी ने बताया कि मंगलवार को थोड़ी देर पूछताछ के बाद डॉक्टर भक्ति मेहारे को गिरफ्तार किया गया, जबकि दो अन्य आरोपी डॉक्टर हेमा आहूजा और अंकिता खंडेलवाल को बुधवार तड़के पुणे और मुंबई से गिरफ्तार किया गया। डॉक्टर पायल तड़वी अनुसूचित जनजाति समुदाय से ताल्लुक रखती थी। इस पूरे मामले और इसकी गंभीरता को समझा रहे हैं वरिष्ठ पत्रकार निखिल वागले।
पायल ने आत्महत्या क्यों की? पायल के साथ तीन लेडी डॉक्टर्स थे। इन तीन लेडी डॉक्टर ने उसे टॉर्चर किया, ऐसा आरोप पायल की मां ने किया है। देखिए, मुंबई जैसा शहर है, हमें हमेशा बताया जाता है कि मुंबई में तो जातिवाद नहीं है, हमारे बड़े शहरों में तो जातिवाद खत्म हो गया। लेकिन इन तीन महिला डॉक्टर ने पायल को इसलिए परेशान किया क्योंकि पायल आदिवासी थी और रिजर्वेशन कोटे से आती थी। बड़ा सवाल यह है कि क्या डॉक्टर पायल तड़वी, जो आदिवासी समाज से पहली पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन स्टूडेंट थी मेडिकल की, क्या उसको न्याय मिलेगा क्या, या उसकी हालत रोहित वेमुला जैसी ही होगी? क्या ये आधुनिक भारत, मॉडर्न इंडिया, पायल या रोहित वेमुला जैसे जो विद्यार्थी है, जो दलित या आदिवासी समाज से आए हैं, उनको उनके साथ सम्मान का बर्ताव करेगा, उनका आदर करेगा, कम से कम उनके संघर्ष का आरोप आदर करेगा? यही सबसे बड़ा सवाल है। जातिवाद का ये जहर जो है वो आजादी के बाद भी, खत्म होना तो छोड़ दो, कम भी नहीं हुआ है। डॉक्टर आंबेडकर जाति संस्था को खत्म करना चाहते थे, उन्होंने भाषण दिया और किताब लिखी अनाइहिलेशन ऑफ द कास्ट, जाति संस्था कैसे खत्म होगी ये वो सोच रहे थे। लेकिन आजादी के बाद जिस तरह का बर्ताव ये समाज कर रहा है, एक तो दलित आदिवासियों ओबीसी की जो प्रगति हो रही है रिजर्वेशन के कारण, पहले तो एससी एसटी को रिजर्वेशन मिला, बाद में मंडल आयोग के बाद ओबीसी को रिजर्वेशन मिला, और एक बात तो स्पष्ट है कि रिजर्वेशन का इन वर्गों को फायदा हुआ है। लेकिन इस प्रगति के कारण बाकी जो समाज है, जनरल कैटेगरी समाज जो है, वो इन जो एससी एसटी और ओबीसी से इनका द्वेष करने लगा है। आप लोकल ट्रेन में जाइए या बसेस में जाइए या फिर मार्केट में जाइए, आपको ये घृणा, ये द्वेष सब जगह दिखेगा, क्योंकि लोग अपनी जाति का गर्व कर रहे हैं और दूसरे जाति का द्वेष कर रहे हैं। तो जातिवाद का जहर जो है समाज के अंग में पूरी तरह से फैल गया है। और अगर हम कहते हैं कि हमारा भारत जो है वो मॉडर्न भारत है, आधुनिक भारत है, तो इस आधुनिक भारत की सबसे बड़ी बीमारी है वो ये जातिवाद है।
अब अंतर्राष्ट्रीय खबरों के लिए चलते हैं पीपल डिस्पैच के साथी प्रशांत राधाकृष्णन के पास।
थैंक यू मुकुल। In the international segment, we first go to Argentina, where the national campaign for the right to free, legal and safe abortion is introducing a bill for the voluntary termination of pregnancy in the Argentine legislature. This is the eighth time this bill is being introduced. Last year, a similar bill was introduced, accompanied by much protests and mobilizations by feminist organizations across the country. The bill passed the House of Representatives by a margin of 129 to 125, but lost by 7 votes in the Senate, a very narrow defeat. This led to thousands of Argentine women being denied the right to abortion and saw an increase in clandestine procedures. The deaths of many women were also reported in the aftermath of this bill. It is in this context that feminist organizations in the country vowed that they would come back with a fresh bill, and this process has begun once again. This is not a dry legal process alone. The presentation of the bill has been accompanied by massive protests known as panvelazos, when women, lesbians, transgenders and people of diverse genders have been waving green scarves and handkerchiefs, which are a symbol of the movement. The new bill provides for abortions for up to 14 weeks after gestation, and further in case of any risk to health to the mother or in cases of rape. Abortion is also declared as a right, which means that any medical professional who denies this could be penalized. Another interesting feature of the bill is that it provides for comprehensive sexual education in schools, as well as the provision of consultancies where women can find out about such procedures. Last year's defeat was a very narrow one, but Argentine activists are determined that this time they will be able to pass a bill which will ensure that women have health and safety across the country. In our second story, we go to New Zealand. Across the world, over the past 1 year especially, we have seen teachers striking for greater pay and more resources in education. On May 29th, it was the turn of nearly 50,000 teachers in New Zealand who took part in the biggest educator strike in the country's history. The teachers are demanding a pay hike of up to 15 to 16%, more investment in schools, a reduction in class sizes, and an overall strategy to ensure that the education sector receives the priority it needs. The strike was launched by the two major unions after negotiations with the government reached deadlock. The government tried to stave off the strike by suggesting a 9% pay hike over the next 3 years, but the teachers dismissed this as they said that it did not involve any structural solutions to the crisis in education. New Zealand faces a major shortage in teachers, and at least 28% of schools in the country have been forced to increase their class strength as a result of this problem. The schools have also been forced to recruit many teachers from outside the country. Unions believe that increasing pay will be a major step in ensuring that education gets the priority it deserves in the country. The strike has also seen an outpouring of support from parents who believe that teachers need all the support at this point of time to ensure that their children also get the right education.
आज के लिए फिलहाल इतना ही। हमारी खबरों को विस्तार से जानने के लिए क्लिक कीजिए newsclick.in पर, हमारे फेसबुक पेज को लाइक कीजिए और यूट्यूब चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए। धन्यवाद।
Thanks for watching.